PCA, or Principal Component Analysis, is typically executed on complete character data. It does not work on sequence types. Fingerprints can only be analyzed by PCA if a band matching table is first generated. We start from a comparison and select the experiment on which we want to calculate a PCA. For ease of interpretation, I will create comparison groups based on the species. I right-click in the heading and choose Create Groups from Database field. Press this button to call the PCA dialog box. By default, Use Quantitative Values is checked, and if the technique provides quantitative information, one will normally want to use this information for the PCA calculation. If this option is unchecked, the character values will be converted to binary. Subtraction of the averages over the characters results in a PCA plot arranged around the origin, and therefore it is recommended for general purposes. Division by the variances over the characters results in an analysis where each character is equally important. I will leave this unchecked in this example. Press OK to start a calculation. In the Components panel, the components are shown with their relative contribution and the cumulative contribution displayed. Also, the components used as X, Y, and Z axes are indicated. The Entry Coordinates panel shows the entries plotted to the first two components. From the colors we see, we can derive that the three genera are fairly well separated. The Character Coordinates panel shows the characters plotted in the same diagram. From the Character Coordinated panel, one can see the contribution each character has to the two displayed components. For example, a group of entries appearing left along the x-axis, whereas the other entries appear right, will have higher values for the characters occurring left on the x-axis and lower values for the ones appearing on the right side, and vice versa. The zoom sliders can help to visualize a particular area of the plot. If you move the mouse pointer over the Character Coordinates panel, the name of the pointed character is shown. Entries can be selected by clicking on one with the Control button held down. Or a more flexible way, by selecting the lasso tool and draw a shape around a group of entries. The selection is interactive with the underlying comparison window. The coordinates of the plot can be exported with File, Export all entry coordinates. To display three components at the same time, press this button to plot the entries in a coordinate space window. Here the entries are represented as three-dimensional spheres in a realistic perspective. You can zoom in and out of the plot with the zoom sliders or the page up, page down buttons. The image can be rotated by clicking and dragging. Individual entries can be selected with control click. Selected entries are contained in cubes and selections are synced to the underlying windows. By double-clicking on an entry, its entry edit window pops up. From here, we can, for instance, view the character values. An interesting display option can be accessed with the last button. Now the entries in the coordinate system are connected by the branches of the active dendrogram from the comparison window. This is an ideal combination to co-evaluate a dendrogram and a PCA. Next, we will calculate a discriminant analysis. Discriminant analysis is very similar to PCA. The major difference is that PCA calculates the best discriminating components for the character table as a whole without foreknowledge about groups, whereas discriminant analysis calculates the best discriminating components for groups that are defined by the user. In case of discriminant analysis, these principal components are then called discriminants. Since discriminant analysis works on user-delineated groups, the comparison should contain groups. I will redefine the groups based on the genus. Call the PCA dialog box again with this button. As a component type, you have two options: discriminants with or without variance. This relates to the fact whether the internal spread of the group is taken into account or not. If you want to account for the internal spread, use the option with variance. The resulting plot looks similar as the PCA plot, but this time the algorithm tried to plot the existing groups apart as good as possible. For three groups, you have two differentiating components, x and y. The discriminating characters can be read from the plot on the right. This character, for instance, is located in the same y-axis orientation as the red group of entries, meaning that this character will have a relatively high value for the entries of the red group and a relatively low values for the entries of the green group. More analysis tools are explained in our other videos.